man with the lady, the mistress of the garden, and another Mother Jones praying on the altar. And I would be the only brother in the church. And how many know they had something when they called Jesus down into the presence?
Yes, sir.
I mean, it seemed like he was delayed, and they would say, Lord, I'm just waiting. I'm waiting on you to come. Let me preach on, get here. But he goes on today, and he's telling us, my God, here, that we need a refreshing of the Holy Ghost in order to heal the sick and have the work miracles. We need the anointing of the Holy Ghost. Brother Timmy, Paul wrote to Timothy, and he told Timothy in the pastoral epistles, he must be proven. How many know a deacon must be proven? He can't have one wife at a time. Hey, y'all find no help here. He must be proven in his family life. His ministry must first start at home. Yeah, you gotta get no hip in here. How many realize that his social life got to be right? His business life must be right. No overseer should have a justifiable charge of immorality and misconduct against him. Rather, my God, as a believer, must have a blameless reputation within the church and without the church. My God, here they ought to mention the name Evan to talk good things.
Right.
But they're only quiet in here.
All right.
How many know there are some qualifications?
Yes.
How many realize that loyalty, the quality of being Lord? My God, in here, how many law brothers do we have in church? How many people can you really count on? How many people can you really trust in to take care of business?
All right.
How many people that are under shepherds and able to build the pastor up and don't have to hear his business in the street?
All right.
How many, oh my God, in here make the pastor look good in the eyes of the people?
All right.
Oh my God, here, how many know God is looking for some qualified men?
Right.
Bring my bag, brother. You can't find it. It's on the back. Yeah, bring it here. How many realize that God is looking for some qualified men? How many realize it takes qualification to be members of the real church?
Yeah.
Ain't gonna find no help now. How many realize that we're so excited about having membership that we're letting anybody and everything in with no qualifications? I don't know, because they have a hoop we put in preaching. But how many know that hooping ain't preaching?
All right.
Woo! How many know you need to exegese the text and know what the word of God is saying in here? My God in here, how many know the pastors are wore out? Can I press a witness in here? How many know they're the first one at church? They have to open the doors. They have to cut the hair on. They have to pay the bills. They have to run and vacuum the floor. But how many know we wonder why they're walking away from ministry? Because why? We don't have any qualified means surrounding us to undergird us. Am I talking all right?
Yeah.
He says, so the sixth part and fourth verse says, but we would give ourselves continually to prayer.
Yes.
How many know brothers need to pray?
Yes.
Oh my God, here we all have to pray without ceasing.
All right.
Pray without quitting.
Yes.
How many realize that prayer is so significant in our church? How many know the church of God in Christ will not establish like the Joneses?
All right.
We didn't try to be like anybody else.
All right.
How many know we were founded upon fasting and praying?
Yes.
How many know we cried out on the altar to God, change the situation?
Yes.
Hey, got no help now.
Yeah.
Tell your neighbor that little short man, go preach in a minute. How many realize that God is able to turn situations around?
Yes.
We prayed till people got delivered. We prayed till people was healed.
Yeah.
We prayed till people was set free.
All right.
God in here, but we will give ourselves continually to prayer. And to the ministry of the word. We have so many illiterate people in the word. They won't read it for themselves. They won't study for themselves. But how many know you need the word of God? Especially in the last of the day when they tell you it's all right to do what you want to do.
No.
But how many know it's restrictions over here?
It is.
You can live like you want to live and still be saved.
All right.
I thought I could preach it here. How many realize the apostle felt that the prayer ministry and the word was the highest work of Christian leadership? How many realize you need to pray constantly?
Yeah.
And one of the brothers, the deacons, how many realize Brother Stephen? And the Bible said that Stephen worked some wonderful works. How many realize he wasn't the pastor? He wasn't a superintendent, but he was a deacon. But how many know what the prerequisite is? That he was filled with the Holy Ghost. Can I ask the brothers in here today, how many of y'all filled with the Holy Ghost? How many got the power to keep you from falling? Oh my God, here Stephen, full of faith and of power. How many know he did great wonders? How many know you don't have to have a title to do great things? But how many know you have to have a relationship with the Lord? How many realize that all I want now, I want Jesus to save me. I want Jesus to deliver me. I want Jesus to heal me. How many know that he is everything that I need?
Yes, he is.
But he's been filled with the Holy Ghost. How many realize that? How many know people around him start getting mad? How many realize that we all have a lot of religious sects? They were talking about the Pharisees and the Sadducees and the Herodians at the particular time. But Stephen was able to start back with Abraham. He was able to go down to the annals of time and brought it to now. And how many know they listened attentively long as he was talking in favor of the Jews? But when he began to tell them about Jesus, how many know people allow you to say God all the time? But how many know when you say Jesus? I tell them, the Church of Christ, brothers, you got to have Christ, God in Christ. How many know you got to have God in you? I feel like preaching by myself now. But he being full of the Holy Ghost. How many know when Stephen was condemned? How many know he proved so that they got angry with him? The Holy Spirit, the Holy Ghost empowered Stephen to perform miracles among people. Gave him great wisdom to preach the gospel in such a way that his opponents tried to refute him. How many know when you're preaching and living the right way? How many know the enemy's going to rise up against you? But you got to stand on the words of God.
Yes.
My God in here. And how many know they led him to kill him? And how many know when Stephen was getting ready and were being stoned to death, Paul considered unto his death, standing there, my God in here, having done no wrong. All he was guilty of was being faithful. Your name might not ever be called. You might not ever be on the program. You might not ever be important in the community. But I stopped by Smithton this evening to just tell you, God is looking for qualified men. I'd rather have Jesus than all the accolades of the men. How many know God is able to do anything but fail? But how many realize something happens here? As I begin to look into the Word of God, Stephen being stoned to death. And how many realize, but when he began to look up and he says, I see Jesus standing. Normally the Lord is sitting beside the right hand of his Father. But every time that a believer get ready to pass on, Jesus, he stands up to welcome you. How many know when I see Jesus, everything is going to be all right? Can't nobody hold it like Jesus. Can't nobody hold it like Jesus. Can't nobody rock it like Jesus. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I got to go home now. When I see Jesus, he's looking up. He sees glory. happened before. He's able to keep you from falling. I hear the benediction. I see the doxology. He's able to keep you. Oh, to be kept by God. Anybody been kept? I've been through the storm. I've been through the rain. I've had a lot of up and down. But to be kept by God. Still self.